Mr. Attorney General, I appreciate your service in the Senate. I appreciate your service at the Justice Department. Consider you a friend. And frankly, I appreciate yesterday's letter saying you were considering appointing a special counsel that you sent to us. But my concern is we sent you a letter 3.5 months ago asking for a second special counsel. And if you're now just considering it, what's it going to take to get a special counsel? We know that former FBI Director James Comey misled the American people in the summer of 2016 when he called the Clinton investigation a matter. It's obviously an investigation. We know FBI Director Comey was drafting an exoneration letter before the investigation was complete. We know Loretta Lynch, one day before the Benghazi report came out, 5 days before Secretary Clinton was scheduled to be interviewed by the FBI, met with former President Bill Clinton on a tarmac in Phoenix. We know after that meeting, when she was corresponding with public relations people at the Justice Department, she was using the name Elizabeth Carlisle. You know, as I've said before, it seems to me if you're just talking golf and grandkids, you can probably use your real name. We know that Mr. Comey publicized the investigation, and we know he made the final decision on whether to prosecute or not. And then when he gets fired, he leaks a government document through a friend to the New York Times, and what was his goal? To create momentum for a special counsel, and of course it can't just be any special counsel, it's gotta be Bob Mueller, his best friend, his predecessor, his mentor. The same Bob Mueller who was involved, we've now learned, in this whole investigation with the informant regarding Russian businesses wanting to do business in the uranium business here in the United States regarding the Uranium One deal. So I guess my main question is, what's it gonna take, if all that, not to mention the dossier information, what's it gonna take to actually get a special counsel?
It will take a factual basis that meets the standards of the appointment of a special counsel.
And is that analysis going on right now?
Well, it's in the manual of the Department of Justice about what's required. We've only had two. The first one was the Waco, Janet Reno, Senator Danforth, who took over that investigation as special counsel, and Mr. Mueller. Each of those are pretty special factual situation.
Let me ask it this
and
way.
And we will use the proper standards, and that's what I only thing I can tell you, Mr. Jordan.
Well, I appreciate
you can
that,
have your idea, but sometime we have to study what the facts are and to evaluate whether it meets the standard.
Well said. So let me ask you this. If in fact
a special counsel.
Well, we know one fact. We know the Clinton campaign, the Democrat National Committee paid for through the law firm paid for the dossier. We know that happened, and it sure looks like the FBI was paying the author of that document, and it sure looks like a major political party was working with the federal government to then turn an opposition research document, the equivalent of some National Enquirer story, into an intelligence document, take that to the FISA court so that they could then get a warrant to spy on Americans associated with President Trump's campaign. That's what it looks like, and I'm asking you, doesn't that warrant, in addition to all the things we know about James Comey in 2016, doesn't that warrant naming a second special counsel, as 20 members of this committee wrote you 3.5 months ago asking you to do?
Well, Mr. Comey is no longer the director of the FBI.
Thank goodness.
We have an excellent man of integrity and ability in Chris Wray, and I think he's going to do an outstanding job, and I'm very happy
about
that.
He's not here
that.
Today, Attorney General.
And I would say,
I'm asking for a special counsel.
The time of the gentleman
and I would
expired.
Say looks like is not enough basis to appoint a special counsel.
Time of the gentleman.